Assalamu alaikum friends. Welcome to this MATLAB Simulink tutorial. In this tutorial, I am going to teach you how to design instantaneous overcurrent relay model in MATLAB Simulink software. An instantaneous overcurrent relay can be defined as a relay that operates when the system current exceeds the predetermined value, and in this relay, no intentional time delay is provided. According to American National Standard Institute and IEEE Standard C37.2, instantaneous overcurrent relay is assigned the device number of 50. Let's discuss its designing in MATLAB Simulink software. For this purpose, just come to MATLAB screen. You can see it shows the Simulink model of the instantaneous overcurrent relay. Friends, before proceeding further, I want to highlight that this model is originally developed by Professor Rodney Tain. This is the reference from where this model can be downloaded. It may be further noted that this instantaneous overcurrent relay block is not available in the MATLAB Simulink library. This block is developed by the Professor Rodney Tain. This is his contribution. That's why I have used this model. It may be noted that this model contains the three-phase voltage source block as shown here. Double-click on it to see its values. In the parameter section, first data consists of phase-to-phase voltage, phase angle, and frequency. You may use any voltage of your choice. However, here in this model, 400 volt is used. Friends, we know that single phase voltage in our country Pakistan is 220 to 230 volt. Now its line voltage or phase to phase voltage will become 400 volt as shown here. That's why here 400 volt is used. Angle and frequency used here are 0 degree and 50 hertz respectively. In the impedance parameter section, base MVA is chosen as 1 MVA. You may choose any value of your choice, otherwise keep this value as it is. Furthermore, base voltage is chosen same as that of original voltage, which is 400 volt. The last parameter is X upon R ratio, whose value is chosen as 7. This is default value. You may change it if you want, otherwise keep this value as it is. Now come to second block of the model, which consists of three phase measurement block. It is assigned with the name bus A. Double click on it to see its values. You can see here we are going to measure the phase voltage. Therefore, phase to ground is selected. You may change it if you want or keep this setting as it is. Furthermore, we are also measuring the current. Therefore, in the current measurement option, yes is written. It may be further noted that same three-phase measurement block is also used here. This block has also the same settings. Now come to the third block of the model, which consists of three-phase series RLC load. This model uses two loads connected at bus A and bus B and has the same parameter values as shown here. You can see the voltage used here is same 400 volt as that of source voltage. All other values are chosen randomly. You may choose any values of your choice or keep these values as it is for your convenience. It may be noted that load at bus B is very much important load. Therefore, instantaneous overcurrent relay is applied here in order to protect this load by disconnecting it in case of overcurrent. Two scopes are used in this model. Scope A is used to measure the voltage and current at bus A, whereas scope B is used to measure the voltage and current at bus B. Now come to another block of the model in which a three-phase fault block is connected here to apply three-phase fault in the model. As we know that in case of three-phase fault, the current is increased. Therefore, overcurrent scenario can be simulated by applying this three-phase fault. Double click on this block to see its values. It may be noted that initial status is set to 0. It means that initially fault is not applied. Switching time is set to 0.04 seconds, which means that three-phase fault will be applied at 0.04 seconds. The fault resistance and ground resistance are inserted here as 0.001 and 0.01 ohm respectively. Let's discuss the last block of this model, which is the most important block. It is because this block is not available in the MATLAB Simulink library. It may be noticed that here 50 is written to represent the instantaneous overcurrent relay. Double click on it to see its values. You can see it is written here that this block is developed by Professor Rodney Tain. Furthermore, it may be noted that there are two sections in this block, namely relay setting and current transformer setting. In the current transformer setting, the first parameter consists of CT primary current. By default, here 300 is written. You may change this value of your own choice. Otherwise, keep this value as it is. Second parameter consists of CT secondary current. By default, here 5 ampere is written. You may change it if you want. Otherwise, keep this value as it is. Furthermore, frequency of 50 Hz and initial RMS value of 0 magnitude is chosen by default here. Now come to relay setting section. In this section, plug setting options are given. These options vary from 25% to 200% with a step change of 25%. These plug setting options are also termed as low setting, whereas in the high setting, multiplier of currents are given from 1 time to 10 times as shown here. Let's discuss how they are working for the calculation of pickup current of the relay. The pickup current is the minimum current in the relay coil at which the relay starts to operate. Now the adjustment of pickup current to the required value is known as current setting. This current setting is achieved by the use of tappings on the relay operating coil as shown in the figure. We know that pickup current is equal to the product of CT secondary current and current setting. Let's understand this concept by an example. Suppose an overcurrent relay having current setting of 125% is connected to a supply circuit through a current transformer of 400/5. Now what will be the pickup current of the relay? The answer to this question is that rated secondary current of CT is 5 ampere. If its current setting was set to 100%, then it means that its pickup current will be 100% of the 5 ampere, which will be equal to 5 ampere. It means that its pickup current in that case will be 5 ampere. Now consider the case of 125% current setting. 125% means 1.25 in magnitude of the original value. Or in other words, its pickup value will be 25% more than 5 ampere, which is equal to 6.25 ampere as shown here. It means that with the above current setting, the relay will actually operate for a relay coil current equal to or greater than 6.25 ampere. By following the same strategy, pickup current of a relay for different current settings can be easily obtained. Friends, if you notice further, you will see there is a down arrow. It means that this block has another subsystem inside it. Therefore, click on this down arrow. You can see it has opened another page and consisting of RMS block, a MATLAB function for instantaneous overcurrent relay, relational operator, and a clock. Friends, I want to highlight here that the system remains same for all types of models. You may use this model as it is for any type of system and keep these settings as it is for best results. Now double click on this MATLAB function block to see its program for instantaneous overcurrent relay. In this MATLAB function, TD is the output, which stands for trip delay signal. It receives the RMS current, CT primary and secondary current values, PS and HS values as the input signals. and based upon these input signals calculates the current magnitude known as CT and pickup current as shown here. In the end, it compares the both values. If pickup current value is greater, then it sends the trip signal to circuit breaker in order to disconnect the load. It may be further noted that to make it real instantaneous overcurrent relay, another 20 millisecond delay is added to include the mechanical relay contact movement time as shown here. Last, double click on this circuit breaker block to see its values. It can be noticed that all the phases of three-phase circuit breaker are initially closed, which means that they are connected. Furthermore, switching time is selected as external. This means that the circuit breaker is waiting for the external signal from the instantaneous overcurrent relay to operate. Friends, at this stage, we have fully discussed about every block of the model. Now let's run the simulation by clicking on this play button. Now double click on this scope A to check the voltage graph. You can see we are measuring the phase voltage, which is 230 volt, but here it shows the voltage higher than 230 volt. It is because this scope is measuring the peak voltage, whereas 230 volt is the RMS voltage. Therefore, peak voltage of 230 volt is 325 volt as shown here. You can see here it shows 325 volt, which is basically the peak voltage. Friends, as we know that the fault is applied at 0.04 seconds, therefore it may be noted that at 0.04 seconds, system current suddenly increased to very high value as shown here. Now double click on the scope at bus B to check its current. You can see it shows that instantaneous overcurrent relay has successfully operated and disconnected the load. It may be noted that at 0.07 seconds, the instantaneous overcurrent relay has disconnected the circuit breaker. Now compare the time of the trip signal with the time calculated mathematically. You can see both times are almost accurate. It means that when system current increases to 125% of the original voltage, instantaneous overcurrent relay successfully detected this overcurrent scenario and disconnected the load at 0.07 seconds by sending the trip signal to circuit breaker. Similarly, you can try to check the performance of the instantaneous overcurrent relay with different percentage of plug setting and high current setting. Friends, this model can be used to complete your bachelor degree FYP, or you can use this instantaneous overcurrent relay in any other standard IEEE model to perform the overcurrent protection in order to complete your master degree research or to complete one of the PhD research objectives. For your convenience, I have uploaded the PDF as well as this instantaneous overcurrent relay simulink model in the form of link in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.